I only left
duty here, heard where about I was from.
What's up, y'all? It's Quan the Bomb. You already know what it is. I'm here at Wayo FM 104.3, upstate Rochester, New York. And I just received the, not humanitarian award, it's appreciation award for hip hop. Basically a lifetime achievement award from my mans in here. Raj, the legend. You see my boy Raj over here. And then my man Cello right here. So they giving out the awards. They do this once a year. They have best designer, best merch, best DJ, and we do all this right here at Wayo FM. This is our home station. You can also check us out 8 to 10 every Friday night, being DJ G Nice, live from the 585. But you know what I'm saying? We all about awards today. So in a little while, we about to head over to my man Chris G radio station.
Right, got him working and shit.
So we here with my man Chris G, a real legend. A West Side legend. What? He don't know when I was a little kid. I used to be kicking Page Street ass. He from Page Street. I'm from Ginny and Sawyer. We used to play them in football. But he was an OG then. You know, because Chris like 1,000. I'm only like 500. You know what I'm saying? But this man right here, the most hours in hip hop history at one point. And he's still on now. And if he ever fell off, he caught back up. This is the name we used to call him back in the day. Mr. Fuck You Down the Dial. He let him have it down to the big station so bad they had to try to sabotage him. Facts. Instead of trying to get money with him, they tried to sabotage him. Yeah, but yo, we here. This is Quan the Bomb, Trap Aid. We want to present my man Chris G with the first ever document. You see, it's the first ever Quan the Bomb 585 Hood Legend Award. This boy's a legend. Beyond control.
King of the North. King of the North. King of the North.
Did someone get a picture
of this?
That
boy's a legend.
King of the North, man. To be honored by someone like Quan. And Quan is a dude I look up to and shit. You know? Quan, the master of the mixtape game. Him and Mikey Pressure used to have it down locked, right? And Street Warriors. I mean, come on. That's Quan the Bomb. Me, I just contributed a little bit. I brought it to the white people. And that's
but
it.
But it started in the hood.
But you still brought it to the white people, bro. And yeah, I did clock in a lot of hours. I feel I do deserve this shit.
That's right. Say that.
I do deserve this
That's
shit.
That's why you got it. That's why we here.
I do deserve
because
this
a lot
shit.
Of times where we from, they don't want to let you know. See, it's the when you real good, they don't give you the awards where we from. When you just all right, or you know the promoter, or you know somebody, they gonna hook
say that
you
shit.
Up.
Say that shit.
They gonna hook you up so they shit. Can get on and get props and get money. Yo, Chris ain't paying me to do this.
Nope.
Wow. I'm just giving this because this is what real love is about. Yo, we got to salute our legends. This
love.
Upstate New York, Quan the Bomb, 585, Trap A, Trap or Die Boys. We in the building with my man Coach last.
I laid in the bed last night. I had a dream that touched me deep down inside.
It's Quan the Bomb, Trap A, 585, Hood Legends. Now, this nigga right here was one of my original youngsters. He's one of the youngest niggas to ever kill every rapper in Rochester. Timbaland Foundation member, original Mix King nigga. Yo, man, took this kid to a battle one time out at like RIT. He had to be like 11, 12 years old. Murdered all the grown rappers. And since then, it's been history. Yo, you see what this say? It's for my man Little Philly, aka Hassan Mackey, 585 Hood Legend Official.
Cross
Jr.
Yeah.
Like, yo, for real. Like, you know what I mean? Like huge respect, bro. Big up. Because, one, it may appear that I'm not even active right now.
Nah, you active.
You know what I mean? But I'm doing stuff for whatever.
Right.
I just feel like, you know what I mean? For all intents and purposes, when you start signing contracts and shit like that, and on the back end, sometimes it's good and sometimes it's not. And I got one of those situations right now where I got a project out in the ether that's still being streamed and so on and so forth. And you know what I mean? The people at the label, they pulled a buddy-buddy with me. but you know what I mean, they ain't shelling out no dividends. So
right.
I figured out other things to do, you know what I mean, because I'm not gonna like just put all my eggs in one basket. But in order to still keep it fun for me,
right,
because I love fucking music, man, I just still make it in the seclusion of my own space.
You already fucking know it's your boy. Ooh fucking wop, nigga. Mr. 5'8 motherfucking 5 on that crew.
Yeah, baby. Quan the bomb. Street Wars Part 2, baby. Let's have it.
Let's have it.
Yo. Yo. I'd rather kill a cop than shoot my man. But you'd rather shoot your man and run a cop snitching on your fam.
You already know how we about to do this.
What's up?
We with my nigga.
Now, you Heart of the Hood.
You don't know who this is. It's the motherfucking Heart of the Hood. We on this nigga's block. We on H Block, Hudson Avenue. So we always got to tell you the truth. This man right here is a pioneer, a hood legend. When I was on the West Side, this the only rapper I ever heard about first. Real talk. Niggas like Oowop, Oowop. I'm like, who the fuck is Oowop? So long story short, I'm doing a mixtape one day. I'm at 407 Chalai, and niggas is like, yo, they dissing some kid named Oowop. I'm like, I heard of him, but I don't know him. I see my man Little E, he like, that's his man. Low key, he might have never told him, but he snuck me a couple of Oowop tracks. I put him on Don Diva, and the rest is history. But this man right here is one of the greatest lyricists upstate New York. Fuck it, the whole New York. Take it down any borough. I put this young gun, he's still a young man, against any nigga, any borough, any city. Yo, it's the Heart of the Hood, man. This right here, go to my man Oowop, read that. The Heart of the Hood. He pumped blood through these motherfucking streets, nigga. And it's a legend.
Appreciate it.
And on top of that, he a veteran, because he done did that time with a lot of people. He a drug war veteran.
Love, man. I really appreciate this, man. It mean a lot to me, man. Real talk, man. So, that being said, y'all already know, man.
We appreciate it. I want to say a couple of things. We're going to ask you a couple of questions. Mm-hmm. Real talk, I was talking about doing this award for years, because I felt like there was a lot of people that wasn't getting their just dues. And I'm gonna keep it absolutely 100. I'm on Facebook one day, and my man was like, yo, the same thing I said with my man Coach, like, they wanna see niggas dead before they ever give us our props. And when he said that, I hit him on the stat. I said, I forgot what I said, but I was like, yo, we gonna fix that. And it's one of the main reasons why I finally did this award, him right here, because he been doing it a long time. They give a lot of people, he got love in the streets. You know what I'm saying? They know he a legend. They know I'm a legend. There's a lot of legends out there, but they don't be giving it up.
Well, mix up though, and I'm gonna need listen up. When they lie to them, they turn them up. Patonito, Patonito. Sherlock Rollout, Ding Dong, Ravens, Walter, Mac with Johnny Chandler.
Yeah, you gotta cut the lights on for the fans. You hear my boy. Legend. Yo, this boy been with Lovers Rock, Melody Sound, Bomb Squad Sound. Yeah, we've been up there at 760 Genesee Street for about 20 years. He beat the Imperial record, the number one reggae record store records, everything. Yo, numerous shows, man. You did so many shows with me. I can go back to The Rock, Eclipse,
Hollywood,
Asmar,
Blue Nile, Hong Kong,
yeah, every party Quintana's, house, they shut
every
down,
every party house we used to do back in the day,
they shut down party house because of me.
Not to cut you. Remember the night when we was playing at Dandridge Party House?
Oh, yeah.
And then Whistle Money Black pulled the record back and the needle flew out in the middle of the motherfucker. And we only had one turntable.
One turntable
for the rest of the night. Had that song. Shit back.
Pull up every song. And they might have fought. They might have played the Kenny Rogers record that night.
Yeah, that's
big shout out to my man Ruben Ryder. Did mad parties with my man, you know, Damo. And it's really just Ruben. We're going to say Damo was throwing chicken wings at Ricky Metro in the Hong Kong.
That wasn't me. Damn, son.
Honor of Wicked Boy Damo D, the Quan the Bomb 585 Hood Legend. It's a real legend. Talk to the people, man.
Yo, listen, man. give thanks to my boy QB. Shouts out to Coach. Coach, we go back way back. Way build back. And destroy way back, man, from when we used to do snacks, everybody.
You got my only dub plate.
Listen, I got your only dub plate, and I need another one.
I got you.
I need another one. You know what I'm saying? But listen, I want to say, QB, you're a hood legend.
Thank you.
Without you, this wouldn't be possible. Shouts out to Chris G for getting that. And shouts out also, too, listen, if you did not see the podcast last night with Wiz and Sight, with Chris G and Ev was talking, yo, they got stories.
Oh, yeah, no doubt.
They got stories. And they shouted out some names. Shouts out to Big Boy Fitzroy. Oh, yeah, shouts out to DJ Dwight. Yo, listen, man, I started from Scorcher Sound to Melody Sound to Lover's Rock. So, there was more people before me. And remember the award we got back in 2000?
2000, I got it. Of the decade, I got it. I'm about to pull that
out. Of the decade.
They don't think that we got awards.
They don't think we got awards.
We've been got awards. I'm the 2000 hip hop reggae DJ of the decade, and I ain't gonna tell you all them DJs I beat. Alright, a lot of your legends was on that. Y'all legends was on that list.
Yeah, and we have the trophies to prove it. Honored by the city themselves, they gave out the awards. See, a lot of people don't know. They just look at us and think, this, that, and the third.
They think everything.
You know what I'm saying? Listen, my name is Wicked Boy Damo D. We started this, man, from 91. No, matter of fact, 1990. So rest in peace, Marlando, that started off with us. Can't forget my boy. Shout out to Brahman, Rob. Shout out to Mighty. We used to do it, carry the speakers down to the YMCA on Arnett and used to do the parties down there. But yo, like I said, respect to my G's. Select the Priest was back there with us. Yo, listen, Delroy, Money Black, Ricky Metro, it's so many other people. Super D, everybody, a lot. Ron, Yellow, everybody. You know what I'm saying? They in the ATL now. A few of them in the ATL doing their thing. Shouts out to Mella Promotion and everybody like that. But I want to thank you, QB.
This is the original Don Dada, Jabani Wailer, making a champion sound called Website. Big up for Chuck Norris.
Sing. Natural vibes. Yeah, you know, see a website sound and a popcorn represent. But like Chuck Norris and Big Ford, take a boy girl by any road. She have her man, but website sound are the only sound she wants.
That's the exact reason why we here today. It's your time, fam. We got the new 585 Hood Legend Awards going to my boy, Chuck Norris. You see, it says, in honor of Chuck Norris' website sound. Because I could have really gave this to the whole website, but you know, when I said that my man was holding it down when Bigger was locked up, I said, you got to get your own. It's for the whole team, but it's for you for when it was just you. When everybody was locked up, everybody was gone, it's just for you. So today, we salute Chuck Norris, live from the 585. Trap A, Quan the Bomb, Coach P, G Nice, Father P, you know what I'm saying? Chuck Norris, we get it for you today, family.
Let's get
shout out to Bigger Four.
Got to.
Red Snapper, Bigger Four.
Bigger Four from the Palladium. A lot of people be like, oh, you and Big Man, this, that, and that. They don't know, like, that's my real brother. Right. Like, that's my brother-in-law. Like, that's my real brother. We family, lived in 641 Garson Avenue. That's how we like to keep it. Enough people say they're this, they that. I'll tell you where we're from. 641 Garson Avenue, Parcells Avenue, where we hustled, made money, all those. Right. Lived the wars, everything.
When I was with Timberland Foundation, they said, you don't know Bigger.
I used to say, you know Bigger?
I don't care about no Bigger. Who's Bigger? I don't care about none of these dudes. He's always bigger for it.
Oh, yeah.
We go to Bigger House and we be recording over there. I was like, who was Bigger? He said, he went to East with you. I said, I don't remember no Bigger, man.
Man, and you know what's funny is your brother was, because him and Richard were friends, and that they lived right across the street from
us. Oh, yeah, Richard's
so
my
when
boy.
You talk about, like, put, like,
yeah. We used to skip at Richard's house.
All day.
Until his dad caught him and Gotti. Skipping Darien Lake, and came home and beat Rich on some. Y'all want to play Ookie? Y'all play Ookie? And whoop that boy ass.
Man, that's the biggest Jamaican you'll ever meet in your life, his dad.
Hell yeah. Man. But listen, man, we gonna let Bigger Ford get on the set. You know what I'm saying? We're gonna get a couple
of
pictures here.
Yeah, he's a bigger four. If a bigger
oh,
four.
Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, man. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. We're gonna
get four. Get out of seven. It's a miracle.
We gonna let
people call me bigger four more than they call me Chuck Norris.
Now, I'm just talking so much, but now we're gonna let Chuck play a couple of dubs. And you know what I'm saying? We're gonna get with this one. We got more coming with Chuck.
Hope that money could wash away the sins. Southside wins. And 6 for 50s and 2 for 10. Southside wins. Ron 80's classic. Still tuck a couple dollars under mattress. You and everything.
J. Greg.
I see the gimmicks, the whack lyric, the shit is depressing, pathetic. Please forget it, I see.
The first joint was 1,000 words off of what album is that again?
Universal Sounds 3.
Oh, hold up. The big Mickey Ficky, my right hand man, just walked up in the building to come hang out with me this evening. You already know Big QB, the general, the other half of life from the 585, along with myself. It cools on. What's good, general? What's popping with you, my guy?
Heard y'all was doing a little quick interview with my nephew.
Yeah, you know.
But you know, forget all
that. Long time you ain't come visit us.
Nah.
You don't ever come visit us.
I had to go get some Christmas gifts because we here today to present my man DJ G Nice.
Come on, man.
Legend Award.
You gotta be kidding me.
My man,
you gotta
be kidding
me. You gotta be kidding me.
Throwback legend.
You gotta be kidding me.
DJ, producer.
Oh, come on, man.
My man done worked with Trap A. We done did numerous shows together, concerts. I mean, he got his history gets broke from Po' Boy. He done worked with numerous artists from his son, Spesh, PA Nit. I mean, I can't even go down the line. He got albums out. He got so much history. But today, this is about you, fam. The legend. G Nice, he gonna tell you about himself more than I can tell you. Cause I want him. I can tell you a lot, but he gonna tell you a lot about himself. Big shout out to Coach, the whole Wayo FM, M Dot. You know what I'm saying? But G Nice, this is for you.
Hey man,
certification for the hood legends.
This is what this is all about right here. This is dedicated to him. All the artists that I work with, man, Quan, man. Like I'm trying not to cry because. Things like this mean more when your people give them to you. You know what I'm saying? When your peers give them to you. That's showing appreciation that they really respect what you do. And like, shout out to JB because he'll tell you, he used to have to steal my mixtapes when I was working at Tasty's. You know what I'm saying? And take them back to New York so cats could listen to them because I never did this for any accolades or any awards. I did it because I love this thing, man. Yo, I appreciate this, man. This is heavyweight. Y'all see this?
Hope that money could wash away the sin. Southside wins. And 6 for 50s and 2 for 10. Southside wins. Ron 80's classic. Still tuck a couple dollars.
Rick, it was a bomb in the knees. From I was born a baby. My main ambition was to choose what I wanted to be.
We about to roll up in here, my man, DJ Little Kirk, Pop Style Boss. Yo, DJ Little Kirk from Principal Sound, Pop Style on Genesee Street. So, if you ever on Genesee Street, right next door to Flash, check my man Flash out. Flash been here too. We come to see Flash one day. He don't even know it. Right here, this is where it started at. Pop Style, Genesee Street. You already see it. You know what I mean? We about to come in here right now. Get this to my boy DJ Lil Kirk. Lil Kirk!
Food will come for, brethren.
You ready?
We're ready for you now, man.
Yeah, man. Food will come for.
I want my oxtail. Want all them ting there.
I want to scrape at the bottom of the pot and all that ting there.
Right, so it's my boy right. It's my man DJ Lil Kirk.
What's up, man?
Respect Reggie.
Every time, every time. Partners in crime. So if you don't know about DJ Lil Kirk, Principal Sound. So this world right here is crazy because this is like a double honor. See what it say? DJ Lil Kirk, Pop Style Boss. So he a DJ. He a selector from Principal Sound. He got one of the number one reggae restaurants. We got reggae restaurants, dance hall restaurants right here. But yo, this is for my man holding it down. Numerous sound clashes, numerous battles. Yo, philanthropist, man, gives out free food for how many years in a row now?
I would say about 12 years.
12 years in a row. Yeah. When you watch the blog, you're going to see the videos of the people standing around the corner.
Rice and peas. Curry chicken. Cabbage. Jerk chicken. Mac and cheese. And your famous jerk sauce, Pop Style sauce. Need some good food, you know where to come at. Pop Style, 227 Genesis Street.
Curry Goat, serving the community. It's a pillar of the 19th Ward, West Side. It's actually not the 19th Ward, but we're going to say it's the 19th Ward for my man. It's the West Side, though. You come check my man out. We present today a 585 dance hall Jamaican legend right here in Rochester, New York, DJ Lil Kirk.
Hey, I just want to say thanks to everyone, man. Thanks, QB and the whole crew, man. It's a honor, man, to be here. Love the city, man. Rochester is a good place to live, man.
So, you know, how long you been here right now?
I've been in this spot 14 years.
14 years. So I was here with him. Lil Kirk helped start a store that me and Gotti never really got to complete, Mixes King Part 2. I came down here one day to help him out. And I remember when it was slow, when it was cold, and there wasn't no customers. Now, yeah, he got so many customers right now. He only open like 4 days a week. Hey, nigga ain't even open on the weekends no more. He getting too much money.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But it's been a long way. So, but yo, how long you been doing this? How long you been with Principal Sound?
I've been with Principal Sound since 95.
There's another story, true fact. I classed Lil Kirk before I knew he was Lil Kirk in the same building upstairs. With Ruben Ryder, Father Lovey, and Dooley. Yeah. We clapped. We used to be King Towers. I wasn't really King Towers. I just came because it was my boys. You know what I'm saying? I left early because I was like, this shit too slow. So I don't even know who won. So I ain't going to say we whooped his ass, and I ain't going to say he whooped nobody's ass. I don't know who won. But yo, big shout to Ruben. Big shout to Principal. Big Principal Sound. So you know what I'm saying? So you originally from what part of Jamaica?
St. Thomas.
St. Thomas, Jamaica. So big
Dumfries.
Shout out to Dumfries. Big shout out to St. Thomas. I always tease him and say from Toronto because I know a lot of family that move up to Toronto.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Sitting on the corner just a waste of time. And when I realized there was the king of the rhyme, I got on the microphone. And what
hey, yo.
You already know what it is. It's Quan the Bomb. We right back at it. Yo, today, we saluting the legend, my man, Record Town Roger, a.k.a. Raj from Record Town. We call my boy the hip-hop historian. You know what I'm saying? Mr. Info, Minister of Information for the 585. You know what I'm saying? So we can go in here, see what my man talking about, surprise him with this ward. Quan the Bomb, Hood Legends. Let's go. Big shout out to Coach Bill Parcells. We here.
Yo, you in
the room? What's up?
Wait, Raj.
Oh,
my boy,
no.
Raj from Record Town. We had to pull him from his show. We didn't want to bum rush the show and make it look like we was taking over the show today. You know what I'm saying?
No doubt.
But it's my boy, Raj.
This dude.
You see what it say? In honor of Record Town Raj.
Oh, man.
Hip-hop is story.
Yo.
You know what I'm saying? It's his birthday. We had to get him
no
on
doubt.
His birthday. You
no
know
doubt.
What I'm saying?
No,
we
want
to present
that.
This man because he's a legend. If you don't know Raj, he going to let you know about him from Record Town. It's one of my mans go way back. This is a real story. I always got to tell somebody.
Oh,
somebody.
No.
Raj was one of my main competitions in mixtapes because he was getting exclusives and pressing them up. He was like Q and Juice, 25 a pop.
He's a Q.
80-minute CD, 80-minute tapes.
No doubt.
80-minute tapes,
no
all
doubt.
Exclusive. I'm like, they coming in, he getting the bread. I said, I got to step my bread up. And get this nigga was killing it. So we got to give him a shout because for real. He's a mixtape DJ. He wasn't on turntables necessarily, but he's a consulting dude. You know, a lot of dudes was using tape decks, when,
yes,
you know what I'm saying? But he's
yes,
a real
sir.
Original
yes,
mixtape
sir.
DJ.
Why, man. Man. Love,
you
man.
Know what I'm saying,
thank
my
you.
Man?
Thank you.
Different type of nigga, man. My socks, $20, man. This ain't even YSL, though. Nigga, this Egyptian must, nigga.
Who would've knew that young snotty nose from Rocky Roads paid attention, studied and polished flows that got me shows. You don't know my name, but Poppy knows he dropping loads. You copping clothes, that's the main reason why my pocket's bulged.
Man, I want to shout out, well, you. I want to shout out the whole Timberland Foundation, man. Gosh, this is funny. I'm just thinking back to everybody I want to know because I wasn't expecting this. You know, I want to shout out Chris G, and I'm going to tell you why. Working in the store, I work with the public, but Chris took me in the homes. And to this day, I'm out places people recognize my voice. And Chris don't know this, but it's actually helped me make a lot of moves business-wise. I have my own business. And people remember me from being on the radio as much as they remember me working in music retail. So I want to shout out Chris. Definitely want to shout out my queen. We was best friends back when I met this knucklehead. And even when I met you, Coach, I wasn't even dating my wife then. We were just best friends. I want to shout her out because she's the one that actually helped me get my business started and encouraged me to just keep being the person that I am, man. And you know what I'm saying, rest in peace to Max. Max was like my little brother. I don't have any younger siblings.
Yes, we shout to Max.
You know what I'm saying? So it was like, it's cool. This is crazy. I was not expecting this.
You already know Quan the Bomb, 585 Hood Legends. Yo, we about to give another legend his award today. Today, it's going to my man, Dwayne, and Material Sound. Big shout out to Short Man, Spanglish, the whole crew. I got him inside the radio station. He thinking that he about to do an interview at the radio station, so we about to walk in here, surprise him right now, give him this award. Yo, big shout out to Son Mackey, UWAP, Chuck Norris, all the previous award winners. You already know how we do.
So this one right here, going to my boy, Material Sound.
Oh, shoot.
So before, yeah, he don't know. He already know how it's going down.
Oh,
so
yo.
Before we give him this award, I got to tell you some history on him. When I first met him, I'm guessing he had to be maybe 14. He might have been younger than that. But I'm working at Imperial Sounds on Chalai at the record store. I know his mom. His mom used to bring him in the store occasionally. I would say once a week, but you know, he had to save up that allowance money. And she bring his big shout out to Mom Material Mom.
Yeah, Mom Dukes.
Mom Dukes was backing him up early, bringing him to the record store. She'd be like, pick what you want. He picking out all the tunes. And I'm like, yo, who is this little dude? Who is this dude? He's going to be a DJ one day. Look at him now, Material Sound. But yo, he been DJing since he was a kid. Like I said, he probably was DJing before I even met him. But I can tell you for sure, he was buying records when I was like 22 or so. He was buying records when he was like 4. That's how old I am. He been buying records since he was about 14, 13, maybe even younger. But he been putting in work to have a sound, a studio, DJ all around the country, all around the world, from New York, Canada, Florida. He doing clashes. He done killed some of my friends. He done killed some of my favorite sounds in Rochester.
Shoot. All right, so I go by the name of DJ Massive D, Material Sound. That's the sound system name, you know what I'm saying? We started like 2000, right? You know what I mean? Rochester. I could tell you like, there's so much history, man. There's so much history, but like Spanglers was like the main MC who came up from Jamaica, straight from Jamaica, right in the basement, you know what I'm saying? Right on Depew Street, right on off of Chila Avenue. That's where it all started. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? We was vibing, me, him, my pops, had a bunch of equipment, you know what I'm saying? We was just like, yo, we should build a sound. So at the time, I named it Massive D, because I'm like, I ain't really know what to name the sound, but Spanglers is like, nah, man. Nah, we need to name it something more wicked than that. So I'm like, what? So he was like, yo, Material. So I was like, all right. So then we just ran with it, you know what I'm saying? So we started that in 2000 and then caught up with Short Man like around the age of 15, 16. His dad used to do a little DJing on the side. So we used to use some of that equipment and try and do little parties here and there until we build up some money and buy our own equipment and stuff. So then, you know what I'm saying, just from the influence and from being embedded in.
Good evening, sir.
Yeah,
was going back and forth downtown in my city. Well, I was a young nigga. You know what I'm saying? I was a young nigga. You know what I'm saying? What up?
Big, what you smoking, a bogey?
Word.
Yo. Run this through, grab me a bag of chips. Quarter on the loose. You know, sell loosies in that store. Corner store, don't sell loosies. Listen. It's the same corner.
Left on the University Avenue Southwest.
It's a different city, and it's the same cop. The same powder, cook the same rap. Story don't change and it don't stop. It's the same corner, just a different block. It's a different city and it's the same cops. The same power, the same rap. Story don't change and it don't stop. First of all, I'ma speak on myself. How I hit those streets about the lust for wealth. How I started doing things that was bad for my health. How I went from loading them guns to packing them shells. How I went from loading fish scale with just on my big scale. Now it's the older cat stories that I tell. See the little youngins and they doing the same. But the only thing that's wrong.
Yo, so I took a long way to come up here to see my son. It's the original son.
Oh,
original
shit.
Son in New York. So let me tell y'all something. First off, this is my young boy. This is son. Yo, son God. Son in New York. Sunny. Sunny. Sunny fucking Rothstein. Oh, I almost got another one. Sunny Kennedy. Mm. Right now we here at Hudson and Alphonse. My man said he needs something to smoke, so we're gonna give him some of this track that he zoo runs first off. But let me see. I got a lot of stories. But I'm gonna give you my first. When I first met my man, they was telling me about him, and he came in to mix as king, you know what I'm saying? And one of the first joints he ever gave me was same story.
Same corner, different
same
block.
Same corny, different block. Mm. You know what I'm saying? We did that on the street hop joint.
Yes, we did.
Then, you know, we did his mixtape, which actually got us a lot of trouble. Because this is one of the first niggas ever from New York. If I'm not the first nigga from New York signed with So Def. This nigga is an undefeated 106 and Park champion. Nigga ain't never lost a battle.
Where I was from, because I knew as long as I was in Rochester, I would not pursue my dreams how I should. Too many distractions, and the first distraction being the motherfucking streets. There's no way I was gonna become who I am today, stand there. So I thank all of y'all for chasing your dream just as hard as I was locally, because it gave me the battery and the gas I needed to pack my bags and go chase my dream for real. And I owe all y'all this. All y'all, I never put out a project. Me and my cousin G-Nice did a mixtape and dropped a mixtape one time before I left Rochester, and that was the biggest and most effort I ever put into recording back home, so shout out to my cousin. But who I am today is truly, truly crafted and motivated by the streets of Rochester, man. I got OGs like Johnny Spivel, Quanta Bomb, Jazzy Kennedy, Fion Kennedy, Big Dave from Mad Flav. I have OGs that has poured jewels into me. And I'm doing my best to live those jewels out. So even when you see Hudson and Alphonse Deli, this is because of my love, dedication, and devotion to Rochester. And there's a chip on my shoulder that I owe my city that. I owe my OGs that. I owe them to show and prove, as we learn in the 5% Nation. I owe them to show and prove that the conversations with me, the jewels in me, are not tarnished, and they did not go respected, and they go at the highest of value of life. So when you see me doing me, I'm not doing me, I'm doing us.
No girl can tell me no I love you. No girl can tell me no I love you. Me no believe again and no, that won't do.
Boy,
me no believe
pressure.
Again and no, that won't do. My girl, how your lies up? You tell me and me wanna touch you. Me ears say you have a man round so. You even have another one round so. You can't trick bad man with no love story. You can't trick bad man with no love story. You can't trick bad man with no love story. I love me mother yard, me invite you. The woman I'll tell me she like you. Me put up on the levels where high so. And you talk about me yard with a knife so. You can't trick bad man with no love story. You can't trick bad man with no love story. You can't trick bad man with no love story.
Hit the lights, cool.
Uh-oh.
It's that time. It's that time, yo.
Oh, man. Got me.
We got him. We already here, yo. We told him we come to DJ today. It's live from the 585 Big QB Coach, DJ Cool One. We got my older brother.
Outlaw Mikey Press. Oh, and I knew to wear Tommy. Because he's Tommy. So I knew to wear the Tommy to dig. I seen him wear Tommy or Polo, I guess. But yo, this is for my boy. You see what it say? In honor of the Dying Till Death. Outlaw Mikey Pressure. So you know I gotta tell you the story. So how I met Mikey P, he used to come buy records from Courtney. He didn't really get records from me because he ain't know me. But he used to be working. And on them paydays, he stopped in and grabbed some of them records. On one day, I had Green Lantern for a party. Green Lantern couldn't make it. And I said, yo, man, you want a cover for me? I got my man Green Lantern, can't make it. You want a cover? And that's how we started. You know what I'm saying? He started doing the parties with me. Later on, started doing mixtapes. I'm pretty sure one thing people don't know about Mikey P and me, we the mixtape kings for real, for real. But one thing about us, how we used to kill a game, is we design our own covers. People don't know that he's a graphic designer too. That's how we killed the game, because we used to do our own graphics. His brother right here probably had the first CD. Before anybody else, I'm talking about, we ain't gonna get how deep that is. That's in a later story. But we used to produce our own music, our own CDs, our own mixtapes. He done did numerous of mixtapes. One of the first ones was Dying Till Death. I wish he had one with him, but it was a surprise. But if you know that CD with the purple hawk on it, it's blue. Some people say purple. There was a purple one. That's like number three. But the first one, who was on the first one? Leroy did?
Leroy Smart.
Leroy Smart was on the first one. Second one was the one, the Credible Hawk. Some of the top reggae CDs ever sold. Too many CDs and names. He done did mad clashes, mad parties with us, concerts, original Bomb Squad member.
Bomb Squad.
Bomb Squad them, you know what I'm saying? It's the original Dying Till Death, Outlaw Mikey Pressure. We're going to get deep into the stories because there's a lot of stories tonight. So we're going to be here on the radio, 104.3 FM. Also streaming, www.wayfo.org. You see it, official Hood Legend Outlaw Mikey Pressure, man. Talk thank to the you. People. Anybody you want to thank or shout out, let them know.
First person I want to thank is my brother, DJ Davey P. Because that's how I got started. My brother was a DJ. When I was 12 years old, my brother started DJing, so I had access to turntables. Shout out to him. My cousin, world famous, Anthony Murray. He used to let me use his turntables when he was at work. My cousin, Mark Hogan, had a dope record collection. And that's on the B-boy hip-hop side when I was scratching behind the back and flashing. That's how I started.
Quan the Bomb, 585 Hood Legend Awards. This man right here is one of the dopest producers ever. He done made mad videos for numerous rappers, Media Movement, Network, Professor, Legend. I can just go on, but you know, we working right now. We here at the 16th Bar. The creator of the 16th Bar, 585 Hood Legend Award winner. It's my man, Shabaka. Holla at the people, man.
Oh, man. This is what I'm talking about. It'll take a hood legend like Quan to give a hood legend like Baka award, you know what I'm saying? Because the powers that be and all the systems around here don't recognize the work that brother put in, you know what I mean? For over 20 years of doing digital media, filmmaking, I don't mentor a lot of people. People watch what I did and do what I do. But I don't hate, because I encourage everyone to do what you can do. So if you can do what you can do, do it. But this goes out to all the hood legends who got the award for the town. You know, my 585 thing, that's what I rep, even though I've traveled around the world everywhere, but I'm from the 585. So I encourage all creatives, whether you do music, you're a writer, director, producer, editor, who do digital media, do your thing, own your stuff. We were talking about that earlier about letting people control you, own what you do. If you're gonna get into the music industry or the film industry, understand the business. You can't play chess and use checkers as the rules, right? So whatever game you playing, know the rules to the games that you play and play them to the best of your ability. And you gotta have a team, you know what I'm saying? Us black people, we gotta stay together. You want millions, you want all the lust and all of that, all the clothes, the cars, and the money and the houses, you can't get it all by yourself. You need a team. Get your team, lock in, keep creating, and own it. And then I'll say this too, and start small. Like, I talk to artists all the time. They wearing all the gold chains, smoking all the expensive weed. They have no promotion on social media. It's okay to have a little fugazi on here and there and take that money and put it into the promotion. Artists out here performing don't got no merch. Own your merch. Video producers. People ask, I need, what kind of camera should I buy, Bach? Use your cell phone. They shoot 4K. There's apps to make your cell phone look like an $80,000 camera. So start where you are right now. Wherever you are right now, do the best that you can do with what you got, and you work that until you climb to the next level. You know what I mean? So I appreciate this award. We need more recognition for people who really put it down.
Yeah, when I was first doing the mixtapes, you know, I had a passion for it. I didn't know where to start, how to do a cover. So I was sitting at home making my own covers. And then when I was passing my tapes around, people was actually feeling them. I think G.I. had a, did G.I. have a record store on Lake?
At the barbershop, right? Was it the barbershop? No, he did have a record shop. Yeah.
G.I., when I was doing the South, a lot of people don't know, man. Like, I went down to the South, and I got caught this buzz, and I was just doing all these South tapes. And then Quan started taking over doing all my covers and giving me light, putting me with the right people, putting me on shows, putting me on big shows. Then, of course, you know I got linked up with Deftown. And then when I got linked up with Deftown, it was just a rap ever since.
We got Damo.
Listen.
Damo got what a story is. To tell.
Yo, listen. I didn't even get to that part. You know what, man? For me to do a full interview or something like that, it can't be 15 minutes, man, because it's a long history of a lot of shit.
You got plenty of time. Too much. That's why we here.
A lot of shit.